Frankie Warren.
Frankie Warren. So we had that fight. Then he goes cunt crazy. Oh, can't get enough of humping and sucking the girl's twat and everything else. I take him to an amateur show in Bayonne. He said, I'll be right back. Comes out 20 minutes here. What is this cocksucking, you know? I go, wow. I'm looking all around. I have Mike, I'm looking for Mike. I see a fucking pair of legs, broad's legs up like this.
In a car?
In a car. How kind of a car was it? It was like a van, you know, big car. And right there, there's this door over there. I see its fucking big head over there. So, you dirty cock. He's muffing the girl. I'm not a liar. I tell the truth. So, you gotta finish the story. He becomes a great champion, you know. Here's a guy who knew every trick in the book that I know anyhow. And plus his own, you know. And I told him, don't look, I'm not the fucking king of the sport, you know. Take a little from him, a little from him, a little from me. That guy, this guy. Yeah, put it all together.
That's a darn
challenge. Use your fucking own brains in boxing. What do you want a guy to fight you along the ring? Cholatin! Lord took now, that's it. Don McFadden. Hit him.
Yeah, right.
I teach him, you know, that was my idol, Walcott.
Oh,
that's
oh.
Why I became a fighter. I swear to God, I love this guy. And personally,
you talking about close. Him and Walcott was real close, brother.
Real close, sir. I don't know who was the white guy, me or him.
But I remember
that. Yes, a guy had a feeling for a human being, I'm telling you. Him and the two best guys in boxing. Outside of you, I don't even fucking count. You like me. Muhammad Ali and Walcott, best for a human being. They are great fucking human beings. Now, you spent some time with Muhammad Ali.
Yeah.
Isn't he a great fucking guy?
Unbelievable. Don't care about a whole lot of fucking money.
Dumb money means shit to him.
He just like people.
Yeah, people. And if you're a good person, he'd look right through you. He know you were.
Yeah, but I remember that fight. Buddy McGriff walked in a circle.
I said, you're gonna have an easy fight with this guy.
Yeah.
Everybody, what are you, crazy? You crazy? Nobody want to fight this guy.
Right, because he was big, strong, and they were saying he was too small.
Too small.
I bet a
That's
video
what they
about
told
that.
Me I mean, about Tat Holyfield. Oh,
yeah, right.
I said, get the fuck out. Holyfield gonna beat the dog shit out of this guy, man. All the guys talking about, big mouth Don Turner, go get Holyfield killed.
What a fucking chin he had. What a body he had. From boxing, he was
if you got a chin and know how to fight, you're hard to beat. That's what I like. That's the reason I like words. GL Del Quays. That was my friend. That motherfucker could fight.
They do that. The other channel. Yeah, don't. That's why they ain't got no damn TV no more with nobody. They ain't got no big fights. Because of that shit. Because of that shit. Because the shit they do.
Why
they say all their cars, they got this one coming up. They all from guy. Listen, the guy that fought Gabriel. A good boy, huh? A good boy. A good boy. They talking about the next superstar of the world. You believe this shit?
Well.
This motherfucker beat Gabby. He's talking about good boy. Good boy. Now he's supposed to be the next super champion of the world. The superstar of the world. That's the kind of shit they do. They channel.
They picking him to beat Andre Ward. That's what the listen, world is saying.
He ain't beating Andre Ward shit. Listen, Andre Ward Showtime made him. Now all of a sudden HBO want to steal him, have him doing all the what they call
commentary.
Yeah, commentary and everything. Now they want to be on Andre Ward's dick. Excuse the words. Now they want to be on his dick. You know what I mean? Now they want him doing all this thing. But Showtime built him. They didn't want him at the beginning of his career. Peterson hit Khan like an octopus, hit that motherfucker like 50 million times. And when Khan would hit him one right hand, he was like, did you see the big right hand Khan hit him with? Did you see the 20 shot that Peterson hit him with? That kind of shit. That shit.
So you're saying the Khan
like, with the American fighters, Danny, like that. Guys like them, they represent this damn country. Went to the fucking duels all overseas, over Europe, all over, okay? Represent this country in the duels as an amateur, got spit on, got booed on, fuck Americans, all this shit. Then the same one that did that to him come to this country and get a red carpet and become superstars. That's the shit that burns me up.
Pretty much like this Saturday, they had
that's the shit that burns me up.
This Saturday,
it's like they got that Chinese boy, yeah, he's doing a pro debut. A fucking two-time Olympian in China come to this fucking country and their fucking TV channel, excuse the word, I'm getting too.
You good.
Okay, come to this motherfucking channel, American TV, come to this motherfucking TV and do a pro debut, and they got him like, he's a fucking superstar, it's funny if he get knocked the fuck out. You know what I mean? And come to this motherfucker, he can't represent China, not America. He wasn't an American Olympian, that's the kind of shit they like. The whole car they got this month, the whole car is about overseas fighters. I'm not racist. They try to call me racist, okay? But when we fought Khan, just because I say, I never met a Pakistani that could fight, they call me racist. But the thing is this, if I'm racist, okay, how many half Pakistanians, half Puerto Ricans you know?
Half Pakistani?
Yeah, half Pakistani, half Puerto Rican. Half Mexican, half Pakistani. Half American, half Pakistani. Half Dominican, half Pakistani. How many you met? So who's the racist now?
So you saying that they don't mix?
They don't fuck no other people but their own. Come on, man. Come on, man. They don't give you a job. They own all the 79. They work for each other. They don't give nobody a job. Come on, man. Seriously, man. Listen, when I was young, all they did was sell cortinas to my family. They knocked on the door and stole your cortinas. You remember that one?
Yeah.
Used to tap on your door and credit. Now they own all the goddamn gas stations. They own all the 7-Elevens. And what we got? What we got? Americans got.
And the gas has got high. Now
that's why this country is fucked up the way it is. They need a president like me to run this motherfucker.
What?
We'll do it again, over. Laying down one night, heard Papa tell Mama. Heard Papa tell Mama. Little boy Boogie. Come out.